Hi guys, today's video is going to be on an interesting topic. A lot of people like to talk about it, but I thought I'll cover this in my video today. So today's video is about Venus in Scorpio and their stare. What does it mean, like the Venus in Scorpio stare? Everybody says Scorpio stare is pretty intense and people really like to get carried away by the whole thing. But what does it mean when a Venus in Scorpio stares at you? And what exactly is this intensity that they talk about in the stare? So before we get started, I'd like to say that I do natal chart readings, I do synastry chart readings, and I also do tarot. So if you're facing a challenge in any part of your life, like say finance, health, career, education, home life, whatever, or if you're having relationship issues, or if you want to get ahead in life in a certain area, you can get in touch with me for a reading. Drop me a message on my Facebook page. That's facebook.com/venusianscorp. Or you can drop me an email at astrolog111@gmail.com and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. I've posted the links in the description box below so you can contact me for a reading today. Okay, so let's get started. So Venus in Scorpio and the stare. What does that mean? So, you know, a Venus in Scorpio is very feeling based. They're very intuition based. They like to suss people out. And the best way they do this is through observing the other person's body language and the general vibe or energy that they're giving out. And the Venus in Scorpio stare is a way to figure out the other person. So when a Venus in Scorpio is staring at you, it's not like an angry stare, like say a fire sign would, where it's all like, I dare you, you know, to stare back at me types. No, it's not like that. A Venus in Scorpio stare is like they are looking into your soul, literally, like you will feel it. When a Venus in Scorpio is looking at you, you feel like they're extracting some information from your soul and really recovering it and then analyzing it for themselves for later. And the reason they do this is because Venus in Scorpio, like basically any prominent Scorpio placement, whether it's Sun in Scorpio, Moon in Scorpio, Mercury in Scorpio, they are all about self-preservation, you know. There is a reason the Scorpio has the stinger, because they need to protect themselves before they get vulnerable with anybody else. So it's the same with the Venus in Scorpio. If they're staring at you, it's not a stare for stare's sake, you know. They are looking at you to really figure you out. What makes you tick? Like what are the things that upset you? What are the things that trigger you? What makes you happy? What kind of a person are you? And I don't mean it at a superficial level, like what are your hobbies or what are your interests in life? This is at a much deeper level. Like they're trying to figure you out at a soul level, at a really energy / vibrational level. So they want to know who you are, like what you're really about, what kind of things make you upset, what were your childhood issues, you know, what did you go through when you were a kid, did you go through any traumas, and if so, why? Like Scorpio is great at keeping secrets, and they are the kind of people who will safeguard your secrets to the grave. Like they don't really spread other people's business around. It's just not in them. Unless it's a lower vibrational Scorpio who's trying to get at you because you did them wrong or you did them dirty. So otherwise, Venus in Scorpio is very protective of people they care about. So, you know, when they are trying to get into a relationship with you, or let's say you guys are in the initial stages, they are trying to figure you out. And actually, this continues throughout the relationship. It's not just in the initial stages, because two people in a relationship are always evolving. You know, they're never the same. They're going to change over the course of the relationship. So even later on, the Venus in Scorpio is going to keep analyzing you and trying to be at the same wavelength as the other person to keep the harmony in the relationship, to keep the equilibrium in the relationship. So Venus in Scorpio stare, to a lot of people, it can be very intimidating. Like, because you know, Scorpio is the sorcerer, it's the healer. So they are like a mirror to the other person. Like they are literally showing the other person what they need to improve or what they need to transform in themselves. And by being a mirror, like, not everybody can look at themselves in the mirror. You know, not everybody is brave enough to do that. Like, a lot of people are scared of their own shadow side, of their own dark side, and they don't want to face it. So when a Venus in Scorpio is looking at them like that, they feel like, they feel scared, like they don't know why the other person is looking at them like that, and they sort of recoil. Like, there is this sense of wanting to cover up and avoid the Venus in Scorpio stare. So a lot of people, they feel intimidated, and the reason they feel intimidated is because they haven't faced their own fears. They haven't, sort of work through their own shadow side. So when a Venus in Scorpio stares at them, it's almost too much for them to take in. And a lot of people, that's why they get scared and they run away, because like, they're not able to handle that level of intensity. And which is good for the Venus in Scorpio, because a Venus in Scorpio doesn't want to deal with somebody who is too scared to face their own selves. Because Scorpio, let's remember this, like, Scorpio is the sign of transformation. Whatever Scorpio comes into contact with, or whoever Scorpio comes into contact with, they are going to transform the other person. So when it's Venus in Scorpio, they're going to transform the partner in the relationship. And usually it's going to be a painful process for the partner, because they are going to figure out things about themselves that they never knew, or they were not aware of, and they're going to be forced to confront these sides to them. And that's going to force the partner to transform, and transform for the better, because Venus in Scorpio is all about alchemy. It's about turning the bad into good and making something useful out of it. And that is why Scorpio rules the underworld as well, because, you know, what is the underworld? The underworld is everything that is hidden, you know, things that you haven't confronted about yourself, all the murky, dark depths of your personality that you are probably afraid to dig deep into. And Venus in Scorpio does exactly that. They don't shy away from their own depths, like things that they need to deal with. Like, a Venus in Scorpio doesn't hide from those aspects of themselves, which is why Scorpio is such a strong sign. Because when you know your own weaknesses, nobody else can put you down for it or tell you about it, because you already know. And you already know how to overcome those. So when a Venus in Scorpio is staring at you, they are trying to see how self-aware you are as a person, whether you've done the inner work, whether you are, you know, in tune and in alignment with yourself. And if they sense that in you, like, even if you're not fully there yet, like, a Venus in Scorpio doesn't want the partner to be perfect. They're not looking for perfection, but they are looking for somebody who is, I would say, humble or flexible enough to be willing to change. They don't like people who are like a wall, you know, in the sense that they're so smug about themselves that they don't even believe there is room for improvement, or, you know, they think like there is nothing to change within themselves. Venus in Scorpio doesn't really like those. They do appreciate a certain level of sensitivity in their partner. And when I say sensitivity, I mean not being a wuss, but like being sensitive to their own flaws and being able to work on it and change for the better. So when a Venus in Scorpio stares at you, that's what it's about. And it's called hypnotic because it is at an energy level. It is at a soul level. It is targeting your sacral chakra, which is all about creation, which is all about manifestation and bringing to life the things that you want in your life. So everything that you've ever been afraid of, a Venus in Scorpio is actually going to bring it in front of you. And a lot of this happens subconsciously. You know, Venus in Scorpio is not even trying to do it purposely. It's just the energy that they carry around with them that makes them do this to their partner without them even realizing it. And it's all happening at a very subconscious level because, of course, Scorpio is ruled by Pluto. And Pluto is all about the subconscious, you know. It's our hidden drives, our hidden desires, you know. If you watch the show Lucifer on Netflix, you know, Lucifer keeps asking the other people, like, What is it that you desire? And it's such a great metaphor for Scorpio, I feel, because Scorpio is all about I desire, you know. And knowing what you really want in your life is crucial to making it happen. And if you don't know what you want, if you don't know who you are, what you're about as a person, then where does the relationship stand? Where is it headed? You know, how does the Scorpio know that you have a plan in your own life, that you're the architect of your own life? So Venus in Scorpio is all about that. So when they're staring at you, first of all, take it as a compliment because it means they're probably interested in you. Or it's just that they find you interesting enough to try and figure you out. Either way, you should take it as a compliment because a Venus in Scorpio doesn't really stare at everybody or random people. They only stare at people who trigger their fascination in some way. So take it as a compliment. So guys, that's what it means when a Venus in Scorpio stares at you. It's not really to scare you or intimidate you. It's really to figure you out and see whether you can vibe with them, whether you can really handle them, because Scorpio is quite difficult to handle in a relationship. They're not everybody's cup of tea. It's a very, very intense sign. So if you can't handle it, stay away and gel probably with the other air signs or fire signs who are much more lighthearted. So guys, that's my take on Venus and Scorpio and their stare and what it means. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you haven't already, please subscribe to my channel. You can click on the bell icon next to the subscribe button so that every time I post a video, you get a notification about it. So, guys, stay tuned. I'll keep posting more videos on Venus and Scorpio. And thanks a lot for watching. Bye.